Hi everyone. So I'm currently in Leeds right now, and I'm currently doing a few errands, just sort of around the area. So as a result, I thought I'd give it a go on an Alfa Power 100 kilowatt charger. Now, to be perfectly honest with you, I have been kind of planning to go to the charger at least, so that's why I haven't really been charging all the week. I've been pretty busy for the last week or so. And as a result, I actually arrived here on 3%. I'm currently actually at the charger. It's just literally, as we speak, ticked over past, I think, about 30%. We can go check the charger in a moment. However, I was hoping to film actually the entire session until I realised that I would have to probably press the button every minute or so to try and get the actual screen to light up. Funny enough, I actually bought a new camera. This means it should be a lot better quality, especially in the dark, which, funnily enough, I do film quite a lot of. Well, two of my videos have been in the dark. Let's go outside and have a look at what kind of speeds we're pulling, and also what the battery percentage was. Unfortunately, I wasn't really able to film it because that's when I realized the screen shut off, but I was pulling at most about 54 kilowatt. Now, bear in mind, I have sort of floored the car, although to be fair, towards the end, I was getting a little bit concerned on battery. So I was doing roughly about 60 miles an hour for the last, well, until you got into the city. I was doing roughly about 60, 65 miles an hour. So let's go outside and have a look at what kind of speeds we're getting. So it's quite simple, really. It's not too bad to actually use the interface. And also bear in mind, the app is pretty good. It tells you when it's available, etc. So anyway, let's go to CCS. And yep, I'm at 31%. I came here at 3%. And we're still pulling roughly about 46 kilowatt. So that's not too bad. It's not as much as I hoped, given that this was a 100 kilowatt charger, but it's about, the ambient temperature is about 7-8 degrees today. So let's check it later. So it's been about 20 minutes since I've just taken a video at 31%. Let's go to CCS. So I'm currently still pulling about 38 kilowatt at 64%. So that's not too bad going. So, from the indicator from the car, we're actually at we've just missing the last two, so let's just go quickly to CCS. So we're still pulling about 36 kilowatt from 75%. That's pretty good. That's not too bad. So it's been a couple minutes from I've just filmed that 75% part, and to be perfectly honest, it didn't suffer from the same problem that I had in the previous video, which I've shown, of the BP Ultra Chargers cutting off somewhere around 70%, maybe 71, 72. From the forum, at least, I have heard that some people are also getting that problem. As you can tell, I've been charging continuously. I've been going in and out of the car. It's, well, 6 or 7 degrees outside, so it's pretty cold. So realistically, it is definitely a noticeable problem with the Ultra chargers, not any of the other ones, including electric highway chargers, the old sort of charge your car DBTs. That's noticeable because they are on the polar network. Any Engini or Instavolt chargers, and also the Alfa Power ones. So I really wouldn't worry about using these ones and sort of leaving the car for an extended period of time while rapid charging. So, I think we're about to tick over. To be honest with you, I'm probably just going to time-slap this again, just so I can show you that we are going to reach that 80% barrier. So as you can see, that, by my reckoning, is somewhere around 20 kilowatt. That is to be expected once you get sort of beyond 80%. As I may have recorded from one of the posts I've posted before, this is quite characteristic of sort of rapid charging. Anything above 80%, it's somewhat not really worth charging up to that sort of level. Not charging beyond that sort of level, at least. I normally charge up to about 85%, although to be fair, all I've got to do is get home. It's about 70 miles away, so I really don't care at this point. So I'm probably just going to go disconnect. So yeah, everything seems to be normal, at least. It didn't do the error that I've received before, so I'm on BP Ultra chargers. So just one last thing. I finished the charge while I stopped the charge. As you can see, I've just loaded up the PDF and it will cost £8.71. I got 34.83 kilowatt from it. It took just under 51 minutes and it's 25p a kilowatt hour. That's actually really good in comparison to, especially, well, Polar Instant. I am a Polar Plus member, but to be honest with you, you know, given that this is a 100 kilowatt rapid, if you can actually take the speeds as well, to be honest, that's pretty reasonable. It's still well within the range of what I would more than happily pay. Unlike Ionity's pricing, which I'll probably go over at some point in another video, once I've actually got all the, well, at least all the facts. So, thank you for watching. Be sure to like and subscribe, and I will talk to you later.